Hello there, hope you've had a great week so far. You're welcome to another exciting edition of News Generation. My name is Faustina Safo, and coming up in this week's edition, pimps at Accra's red light districts abuse minors and subject them to prostitution. Also, cardiovascular disease accounts for 17.3 million deaths annually. And pupils of New Ningo Primary School get a junior high school block after 60 years. You don't want to miss any of this. You're watching News Generation. Do stay.
News Generation, supported by
Cowbell with Vitamin.
The Cowbell Vitarich formula has been stolen. Get it back at all costs.
Testing Cowbell with VitaRich has the 28 vitamins and minerals you need to be at the top of your game. Delicious, nutritious Cowbell with VitaRich, our milk.
Welcome back from the break. Now, you can join our conversations online on Facebook at News Generation GH and on Twitter at News Gen GH. Now, onto our first story. Girls for Rent, that's the title of latest Joy News Hotline documentary on the miners in Accra's red light district. Joy News reporter Favour Nunu went undercover to reveal the pimps controlling the girls and the abuse these miners are subjected to. Watch this.
A prostitute work, there will be some work, will be spiritual work. Yeah.
But it's not a job. But I wanted money. That's why I'm working.
This one right here is for the people.
Just like 8 years, 10 years, 12 years. No bad show.
Hey, yo, D. Let's go all the way in on this one.
Hey, Biana, fashion condom. I know, yen. Be a condom in the person. I know so on country, say be a condom a pipe.
Cause it's not like the future depends on it. You say the animals in the zoo. Had a chimpanzee, them a make big money. This is how they meet the villages. On TV, the picture is savages and villages. And the scientists still can't explain the pyramids.
Prostitution, the oldest profession known in the history of mankind. It is, however, unacceptable in many traditions and cultures all over the world. It is the exchange of sexual acts for money. In the colonial days, men who visited the brothel usually paid 2 pence for one round of sex. As the practice of paying 2 pence for sex became common, people began to call those areas tutu line and call the sex workers tutu. My name is Favour Nunu, and here on Hotline, I want to take you on a journey through the stories of some child sex workers who roam the dark corners of the streets of Accra and rail stations offering sex for money. Their lives, fears, and hopes as they trade their pride to escape illiteracy, poverty, the harsh reality of bad parenting, and a society which no longer cares about what happens to the most vulnerable population. To get more information, I am planting a young lady undercover as a child sex worker. This was a first step at getting to know more about the operations of these girls without raising suspicion.
People that's just ignorant and scared of the truth. We patient.
the railway lines, I saw over 100 girls, underage girls. They were dressed indecent, to specify short skirts, tight short skirts, tight short straight dresses. But in order to attract clients, they dance sexually, trying to arouse the men around to get customers. I saw over 100 girls there. There were also over 100 guys there. Half will be younger than 18, and then the other half will be older than 18. That's those older than 18 usually are those in charge of the drinking spots, the girls, the condoms and the rooms, the wooden structures over there. There are some structures over there, wooden structures, rooms. They are charged 20 cedis and 15 cedis per night. It depends on the room. 20 cedis has a fan, a carpet and a bed. Then 15 cedis has the bed and then the carpet, but no fan. I met a lady there called Beatrice. Very friendly lady. She tried telling me about the rules and regulations over there, the do's and the don'ts. Over there, everybody has a boyfriend who is practically the protector of the girl. Yes, and you should dare not go near any of the girl's boyfriend, because if you are found with the boy, the girl could either use blade to deform your face or hurt you anywhere, or just use a sharp object to stab you. So she even tried giving me a boyfriend over there, whom she says is her brother, whom is a driver, drives to Kumasi and back to Accra. So what I discovered whilst undercover was that the ladies always make sure they carry sharp objects with them, and even if they don't have such objects on them, they make sure they get one when they are in the hotel room, just to protect themselves from their clients. You superstitious, throw so over your shoulders, make a wish for the day, cuz like somebody got a doll of me, sticking needles in my artery, but I can't feel it. Sometimes like part of me.
One thing became apparent. Most of these girls come from Kokumba, a slum in Accra. Kokumba as a melting pot functioned as a squatter camp for displaced Kokumbas. But today, it has become a township with many different people trying to find space they can call home. For many of these folks, poverty is a daily reality.
We are from Bankum, one Z, alias Onlooking. I got to be some
Dr. Akpabli, a senior lecturer at the University of Ghana Department of Sociology, explains that excessive discipline by parents and the breakdown of the extended family system could be blamed for the increase in girls on the streets.
The family as a first point of socialization is very important. And so that is why it is important that we bring children the way we want them to be. The extended family system is diminishing. The family system is becoming more and more nucleated. It boils down to child rearing practices, particularly when the child is becoming an adolescent. The child has certain natural tendencies to display. The child is not by nature arrogant. The child is not by nature disobedient.
Unbelievable, right? Yes, that is what is going on right here in Accra. Girls 8, 6, 7, 8, 10 and 12 into prostitution. Well, we'll bring you more of that story in our next edition. Moving on, cardiovascular disease is the leading cause of death globally, accounting for 17.3 million deaths annually, a number that is expected to increase to more than 23.6 million in the year 2030. To raise the awareness of heart-related diseases, as well as raise funds for children suffering from such diseases, students of Morning Glory Montessori Child Development Center embarked on a health walk dubbed Save a Heart. I was there. Trust me, it was fun.
Well-attended walk started from Teshinungwa Estates down to Nungwa Junction Mall. Dubbed Save a Life, the walk sought to raise the awareness of heart-related diseases, which accounts for 17.3 million deaths annually, while giving parents and children an opportunity to bond and burn fat at the same time. To raise funds for children suffering from heart-related diseases, parents hit the streets selling branded Lacoste. After the walk, students were taken through exciting aerobics. Na Ejekai Beduanu, head of the department Morning Glory Montessori Child Development Center, shared what motivated the gesture.
The school over the 20 years have lost 4 children due to heart conditions and 2 staff members. So the management, the owner herself personally has been donating to the Heart Foundation over the years. However, this year, our school prefect, who is now outgoing, wanted to leave a legacy for those behind, and she wanted to organize this health walk to bring more awareness to the fact that there are diseases going on and how we can help by walking every day to improve our health.
For participants, it was a sweaty experience.
We walked down the very far away, almost 8 kilometers, and it was very exciting. My pal, we were pushing each other, running, walking, people, it was very nice.
Some people were very tired, like they were telling me to hold their bags and things. And then I told them they have to man up and walk because this exercise and exercise is good.
For Joy News, for Sina Sapo.
We're taking this quick break, and when we come back, we'll tell you about Pro MPP Group Delta Force and the updates on that. Do stay.
The Cowbell VitaRich formula has been stolen. Get it back at all costs.
Testing Cowbell with VitaRich has the 28 vitamins and minerals you need to be at the top of your game. Delicious, nutritious Cowbell with VitaRich, our milk.
Welcome back from the break. Now, a circuit court in Kumasi has fined the 13 members of Pro NPP Group Delta Force who escaped from the court 2,400 Ghana cedis each. They were convicted on their own plea and fined 200 penalty units. A penalty unit is 12 cedis, and they are to pay this amount or face a 3-year jail term. They are also to sign a bond of good conduct or be sent to jail for 2 years. Yes, harsh, isn't it? So on WhatsApp today, we're asking you, do you think this punishment is enough? You'll be sharing your views with us.
Yes, it's enough because there were more and the 13 Delta Force were there and they were forced to go out and later learn their mistakes and came back to come in. Said they are wrong.
I think the fine that they have been asked to pay is okay because that was their first time doing that and they were forced. And those people who came to raid the court, they outnumbered the suspected people, so it's okay.
2,400 Ghana cedis is enough since that's what the judges have asked them to bring out.
I'm of the view that the fine is enough for them because they were not forced there. It's not their fault, but rather they were forced by their colleagues. And I'm of the view that finding them will not solve the problem, but because most of them do not have that money to pay for that.
Next time they commit such a crime, the punishment should be tougher.
I think the punishment is enough because they were forced to plea and they submitted themselves to the court custody. But the other members of the Delta Force escaped without submitting themselves. So I think the 13 members should be forgiven and other members should be jailed.
What they've done is not too much to increase the price for them, and this was their first time doing it. So since it was their first time, they should maintain the price.
Yeah. There's more news in Local News Round.
8 persons arrested for allegedly storming a Kumasi court to free members of the pro-NPP vigilante group Delta Force have been remanded. The 8, also said to be members of the group, were charged on Monday for their involvement in the escape of 13 of their colleagues who have since turned themselves in. Lawyers for the 8 say their clients are innocent and that they were nowhere near the said Kumasi court where the incident took place. The Sekendi High Court, presided over by His Lordship Justice Edward Amwakwa Sante, has refused bail to the 5 alleged Chinese illegal miners and their 5 Ghanaian counterparts who were arrested for illegal mining on the Ankobra River on the 24th of March this year. The case has been adjourned for the second time to April 24. Gospel musician Joe Metal has made history by becoming the first gospel artist to win the Artist of the Year award since the inception of the awards in 2000. To make that record, the Onwenwenni hit singer beat EL, Sarkodie, Miss V, Stoneboy and Medical to win the awards. He therefore holds the bragging rights as the best artist in Ghana for a year.
While Australia has expressed interest in Ghana's education, agriculture and mining sector, Australia's Trade Commissioner for West Africa, Brendan Cohn, believes trade ties between both countries could be further strengthened. He was speaking on the sidelines of an educational fair organized by the Australian High Commissioner at the Moving Peak Hotel, Accra. Yes, I was there. Watch this.
The Education Fund Fair organized by the Australian High Commission sought to provide a platform for Ghanaian students to explore study opportunities in Australia. Dubbed Future Unlimited, the fair had 14 Australian universities in attendance and over 1,500 students were taken through various study opportunities, cost, visa application process and scholarship programs in Australia. Australia's Trade Commissioner for West Africa, Brendan Cohn, speaking on the sidelines of the fair, expressed Australia's interest in Ghana's agriculture and mining sector.
The relationship's good, but it's got a lot of potential to grow more. So education is one element, mining and mining services is another. But we definitely want to look a bit further into agriculture, water, where we think Australia and Ghana can really collaborate and do some good work together.
Frederick in September, President of the Ghana-Australia Alumina Association, seized the opportunity to suggest possible ways government could deal with the recent surge of suicide cases.
The government has instituted this LEAP program where people who need assistance are given. But it will be good if those who really need assistance, their biodata is captured, so that if at least the minimum needs of nationals can be met, so that from there you know that okay, at least I have something to eat, I have a place to eat, I have a place to sleep, and all of that, so that one can serve as a base from which other support can come.
Some participants share the experience.
Look, it's been fantastic actually. This is my first time to Ghana, so I was really unsure what it was going to be like. But from our university, Edith Cowan University in Perth, we've had fantastic attendance at our booth. Lots of students interested in master's degrees, very well qualified students, very high levels of English. They seem to know what they want to do, which is really great for us as well. They seem to have an understanding of what the opportunities are for them. And we've been sort of 3 or 4 deep in terms of inquiries at the booth, and we've got 4 staff at the booth. So it's been, you know, fantastic for us.
We've got a lot of students that are interested in the mining industry, the oil and gas industry, really wanting a good, solid Australian qualification. So we've been really pleased. And I think seeing some good, genuine students wanting to study has been fantastic.
For News Generation, Faustina Safo.
For almost 60 years, pupils who passed out of primary school in the Greater Accra Region town of New Ningo walked many miles to attend junior high school in a nearby town. The situation meant some of them missed classes. While this situation is now history following the intervention of the CEO of Multimedia Group, Kwesi Chum, and his siblings, the family has built a new junior high school block for the community. Now, Joy News' Kwete Nate explores how the intervention is offering hope to the last batch of Class 6 pupils who would be passing out this year. There's more in this report.
At about 11 a.m. and pupils of New Ningo DA Primary 6 class are busy writing their second term exams. Beads of sweat have already formed on the foreheads of many of the pupils barely 15 minutes into the test. These pupils should have been preparing to walk many miles to junior high school daily. It's been a ritual for the past 60 years.
I have to pay my lawyer fare from here to come from. So when we got the new generation here, so that it makes me happy because we will not spend our money too much for going back from in and out.
When I started school, I want to complete it at where I started, not to go and look for other schools and go there again.
Since its establishment, the New Ningo DA Primary has been without a JHS block. Nate David Adu is the Class 6 teacher. He's sad the school does not benefit from the hard work they put in nurturing these children due to the absence of a junior high school.
Okay, I think we not having JHS block is a very challenge and problem to us because when we came here, we came here that we are going to teach in GHS, but when we came here, we don't have any GHS. So we decided to be in the primary school. We did our best to give out these children. After the children leave out the school, every school that they go, students from these schools rather become the champions in those schools. As I'm talking to you now, I want to go to Old Ningo, the Presby. One of our students that left here is a main pillar of the school. If you go to Pram Abia, there are also students there who are performing marvelously. So I think we not having GHS is a challenge and a big blow to us because parents and the community is not seeing our output. And late every day they think they're going to do anything. But when we meet among in the circuit, we the teachers see that these are the children that we have brought, but the parents in the community are not seeing our output because we don't have no teachers.
I have come to meet Dinate Afio. Her child completed a New Ningo DA Primary 3 years ago. She tells me she spends 60 days every day for her child's transportation to and from school and feeding. That's a lot of money for many people in this community of mainly low-income earners.
When he completed from here, there was no GHS, so I transferred him to a different school. I have to pay his transportation before he goes to school. His transportation and feeding fee is 6 cedis. On days that I don't have money, he rises early in the morning and walks miles to school.
It will be a different story for this year's batch. The school now has a fully finished JHS block following a special intervention by Multimedia CEO Kwesi Chum and his siblings who funded the project. Assistant headmistress of the school, Charity Teria, says the block would enable the school to impact the community.
I feel very happy with all my colleague teachers. We are very happy because now our school is complete, unlike the first. So now we produce the result of on our own. Because when we send them to the other schools, because they don't complete with us, when they go, they perform, some too don't perform, then sometimes they blame the primary schools. But now we have the result of our own. We produce them from KG through to the BEC room and they come back and we know, yes, we are doing it. We are doing it.
Let's check out what else has been making headlines internationally in International News Route.
Nigeria's military says it has released 593 people held on suspicion of being linked to the militant Islamist group Boko Haram. The chief of army staff directed that those arrested be released unconditionally if found not to have anything to do with the riot or Boko Haram. Those freed included elderly people and children. Supporters of South Africa's embattled President Jacob Zuma interrupted a speech by sacked Finance Minister Pravin Gordhan in which he condemned corruption in the Govern African National Congress and warned that the party could lose the 2019 elections. The crowd burst into songs praising. The scandal hit Mr. Zuma at a memorial for veteran anti-apartheid activist Ahmed Kathrada in the president's political heartland of KwaZulu-Natal and supported his controversial decision to fire Mr. Gordhan. A camp housing 1,500 migrants in North France has been destroyed in a fire that officials said began during a fight between Afghans and Kurds. At least 10 people were injured when the fire tore through closely packed huts at the Grand Saint camp near the port of Dunkirk. The population of the Grand Saint camp has grown since last October's destruction of the jungle camps near Calais, about 40 kilometers away.
Well, do you remember the famous American children's television series called Sesame Street? Yes, I remember. The program is known for its educational content and images communicated through the use of Muppets, animation, short film, humor, and cultural situations. Well, the show has undergone a lot of significant changes throughout its history, and now Sesame Street has introduced its first autistic character to help young audience understand what autism is and what it means to be autistic. This is what's trending.
This is our friend Julia.
Oh, hi Julia. I'm Big Bird. Nice to meet you. Oh, Julia? Ellen, I don't think Julia likes me very much.
Oh, no, you two are just meeting for the first time. She has autism. Hmm. She likes it when people know that.
Autism? Well, what's autism?
Well, for Julia, it means that she might not answer you right away.
Yeah, Julia doesn't say a lot.
That's right. And she may not do what you expect, like give you a high five.
Yeah, she does things just a little differently. In a Julia sort of way.
Oh. I think that's a yes.
Yeah. Oh, Julia, you're bouncing like a rubber ball. Boing, 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 boing. Okay, Julia, one more thing. Todd, you're up.
It's been another exciting edition of News Generation. But remember, you can still be interactive with me on Facebook at News Generation GH and on Twitter at News Gen GH. My name is Faustina Safo. But before I go, guess what? The man behind the screens, and he is part of News Generation team. Today, his son is celebrating his five-year-old birthday. Yay! His name is Ernest Annan, and his son's name is Austin Annan. So congratulations to you, Austin Annan, at Dromona International School, North Dakuma. We wish you a very happy birthday. Enjoy your day. Send me the cake, because the cake is very important to me. For myself and my production crew, we say adios.
News Generation, supported by
Cowbell with Vitarid.